lot of the areas have been covered by other members, but I want to go back to the opioid surcharge because I'm confused as to how it would flow, and maybe if we hear it one more time, it'll sink in. So right now, we'll take OxyContin is manufactured by Purdue Pharma. So Purdue Pharma could sell it into New York State to either hospices, nursing homes, healthcare institutions, or more likely they're negotiating with pharmacy companies like CVS, Caremark, and how would it affect them? Who would pay the surcharge at that point then?
Again, the surcharge is on the first sale into New York State. And that's really because for the same constitutional issues, we can only reach that first sale into New York State. If the manufacturer is selling directly into New York State, then the surcharge would be applied again to that manufacturer. If the manufacturer is selling to a distributor like CVS Caremark, and then CVS Caremark is selling it into the state.
Okay, so stop at that point. How do we then prevent CVS Caremark from passing the cost on to the consumers at the counter in the form of an increased copay? Because I think we all agree we need to do everything possible to reduce the over-reliance of opioids and the corresponding effects that it's having on our state. I think everyone agrees with that. It's just, what do we do to prevent them from passing it on to the patients who are already suffering with the addiction issue? And what we do know is if you make a product too expensive for patients, they are going to turn to the tried and the true and the cheap, and that is heroin. So I think we just have to be careful that as we go down this road, that this is more of a comment than a question, that we prevent them from passing it on to the patient. Anything we can do to prevent people from going into the black market is important. And on that issue, I want to turn to, it's a very small proposal in the budget. It only produces $3 million this year and $5 million annually thereafter. It would be the health tax on vapor products. And the executive proposes to regulate and tax vapor products in a similar manner as cigarettes. Vapor products are defined as any non-combustible liquid or gel, regardless of the presence of nicotine. Fine.
Right.
But I think we need to exempt the medical marijuana program. The vast majority of patients that don't use sublingual or oils use the vaporizing method of delivery. The cost is already exorbitant for patients in New York State because of the size of the market, and we control the price. I would just ask that we exempt that vaporizing method for medical marijuana patients. Thank you.
Senator, just if you can, on the opioids, because I know a couple have raised this the same question. There's two parts to this. One is there are some price protections in place for consumers with regard to price, so we are sensitive to that. The other part is there's an alternative policy rationale for it, which is also a deterrent. So we all know that there's an overuse of opioids, and the amount of prescriptions that are being written are probably far more than need to be. We also know that there are many alternatives that a lot of pharmaceutical manufacturers, hospitals are practicing. They have non-opioid emergency rooms now. Mm-hmm. They're using alternatives. So also the desire here is also to promote alternatives. So a deterrent necessarily for opioids if you have to, but there's an overuse problem, and imposing the tax also might discourage some use and promote some alternative pain relief as well. Where the line is and what that does, I think we have to work on that. But there's an alternative policy rationale besides just funding the program.
I agree totally with that. I'm just, from experience and seeing it out there, if you push patients too far too fast, they will not necessarily make the best decisions. But with respect to having an alternative option out there, we do have one. It's called medical marijuana. Unfortunately, it can't be used the same way, and it's incredibly expensive. So again, let me just reiterate, if we could exempt medical marijuana patients using vaporizing as the method of delivery, I think that would be only fair to people who are already paying a very high cost for a product that's providing the relief that is an alternative to opioids.
We'll certainly take a look at that. I would note that the proposal to tax vapor, would put the administration of the tax on vapor in the same section of the tax law as the tax on other tobacco products. Mm-hmm. And medical marijuana, the distribution structure for medical marijuana is very tightly controlled and is outside of the retail chain that the cigarette taxes generally apply to.
I just mention it because the language says regardless of whether nicotine is present. So Just want to make sure. It's the pen itself.
We'll take a look at that, but I at the same time, to provide some comfort, that tax structure relates to tobacco distributors, to tobacco retailers. It's falling into that same tax structure.
Okay, thank you.